Good morning, children. So today we are going to learn about the ing sound, okay? And when ing is put after a word, what does it do? So we have been learning about Mr. Ed, ed, word endings, right? When ed is put at the end of a word, what does it do? It changes the tense of the word, and that means the thing happened in the past. And then we learned about the three different sounds of ed. Yes, which one is your th, one is your loud and noisy d, and then your one was your ted ded it, right? So let's get started. And now we have heard of this ing a lot of times. If you're strong and you know it, say ng, right? So now what does it do to the words? Let's go and get started. Okay, so the ing verb. So what is a verb? Verb is something that shows what, if you are there, if you, what you are doing, what you are saying, what you have, or what you are. So a subject, what a subject does. Suppose you are talking about pencil. So what a pencil does, if pencil says something, so what does it say? Does a pencil have, or what a pencil is? Okay, action, any type of action. Okay, a verb shows what a subject does, says, has, or is. So now there are spelling rules for forming ing verbs. Okay, so we are going to learn about that. Spelling rules for ing verb. When a verb ends with the suffix, now suffix means your ing, your ed, they both are suffix. क्योंकि हम उसे वर्ड के एंड में लगाते हैं. रिमेंबर, मिस्टर एड कम्स एट द एंड ऑफ अ वर्ड, सो मिस्टर एड इज अ सफिक्स. Now today we are learning about another suffix, which is your ng. So when a verb ends with the suffix ng, it is known as ing verb. So कोई भी अगर वर्ड ng से एंड होता है, ing सफिक्स से, so that is called ng verb. Okay? Now verb is any word that is showing you an action. Okay, so this is your first rule. It's called ng verb. Then the ng verb often show the action that is happening, like walking. So means if I would say Miss Abhilasha is walking. So Miss Abhilasha is the subject, and what is Miss Abhilasha doing? She is walking. Miss Abhilasha is eating. Okay? Like here, eat, and eat के end में हमने लगाया ng verb suffix, so eat became eating. So eat plus ng became eating, eating. Right? ing. So eat is a verb क्योंकि उससे action पता चल रहा है कि somebody कोई खा रहा है. Now eating is your ing verb. And it also shows that that something is happening right now in the present. Like ed shows ki pehle ho chuka hai, it has happened in the past, but ng will show shows ki it is happening right now. Miss Abhilasha is eating, aur past mein bolenge Miss Abhilasha ate. Okay, eat ka past hota hai ate. We don't put ed at the end of that word. Okay. When a verb ends in e, drop the letter e and add ng at the end of the word. Now, these are your rules, okay? Remember them. So now, if there is a word, like in the word eat, the spelling was e, a, and t. So, no problem, you just add ing. Now, if you have a word, अगर कोई word है आपके पास, that tells you, that has this ई एट द एंड ऑफ इट, उस वर्ड के एंड में अगर ई आता है, ई, सो यू हैव टू ड्रॉप दैट ई, उस ई को आपको हटाना होता है. ओके, and then only you can add ing. So if there is e already, so you cannot add ing. Okay. Now here, make became making, game became gaming. Now you can see when make and ing has being added, e is dropped and e in game is also being dropped. Dekha? Yahan e nahi hai isme. M-A-K, seedhe ing, not e. So you have to drop e. So this is the second rule for using ing. Remember that, okay? Just remember these things. So you have to drop e to add ing. Now third, when a verb vowels like a, e, I, o, u come before the ending consonant, the consonant is repeated or doubled. Okay? So what happens is now, if you have a word, jaise aapka ek rule hai, agar e aata hai, so you have to drop it. Now the same way, if you have a word which is ending with any consonant. Consonants are A, E, I, O, U ke alawa jitne bhi hain aapke. Like your B, C, D. Now E is a vowel, so E won't be there. B, C, D, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, V, W, X, Y, Z. So these are your consonants. Your word is ending with any of the consonant and usse pehle लेकिन वोवल यूज होता है ओके लास्ट कॉन्सोनेंट से पहले इफ देर इज अ वोवल दैट इज बीइंग यूज्ड दैट मीन्स यू हैव टू रिपीट द कॉन्सोनेंट जो भी कॉन्सोनेंट लास्ट में आया है उसे रिपीट करना है दिस इज अ लिटिल कॉम्प्लिकेटेड वन बट आई एम श्योर यू विल गेट होल्ड ऑफ इट इन नो टाइम नाउ सी ए नाउ यू नीड टू रिमेंबर योर वोवल्स वेरी क्लियरली फॉर दिस ए आई ओ यू Okay, before the ending consonant. That means at the second last, aapka agar koi vowel aata hai. And the word is ending with a consonant. So like here, you can see the words run. R-U-N. So run is ending with a consonant. N is a consonant at the end of the word. And before the consonant, we have a vowel, which is your U. So what we'll do is, N will be doubled. जो एन कॉन्सोनेंट है इसे हम डबल कर देंगे यहां पे, ओके जस्ट लाइक यू ड्रॉप ई यू जस्ट एड अनदर कॉन्सोनेंट इफ यू हैव अ वोवल बिफोर इट सो सी लुक एट द वर्ड अगेन आर यू एन सो एन इज अ कॉन्सोनेंट एंड एन से पहले यू इज योर वोवल यस एंड एंड से पहले आपका वोवल है सो एन हम डबल कर देंगे एज यू कैन सी रन एन एक बार और जुड़ा जाएगा इंग Same goes with chop. Now, p is a consonant. Now, p se pehle o is your vowel. So, p will be doubled. You're going to repeat that. So, chopping. Chopping. This is why there are two p in chopping. Okay? So, this is it. Now, you need to know your vowels very well for this. Okay, you need to know your vowels very well for this. And these are the only three rules that you must know. That you must know. Okay, in case of confusion, please drop a message.